This how-to video will show you how to perform the preoperational checks, including calibration of the flow sensor and a breathing circuit tightness test. You will also learn how to perform calibration of the oxygen sensor and zero calibration of the CO2 sensor. This educational video does not replace the relevant instructions for use. Be sure to read the ventilator's operator's manual, as well as instructions for use that accompany the humidifier or other devices, breathing circuits, and other consumables. Pay particular attention to important safety and hygiene information. Always run the preoperational checks before connecting a new patient to the ventilator and after connecting a new breathing circuit or any new component. The whole procedure takes approximately 5 minutes. Before starting the preoperational checks, ensure that the ventilator is connected to both primary power and a gas supply. Ensure you are using the correct flow sensor for the patient. If there is a mismatch between the selected patient group and the type of flow sensor connected, calibration will fail. Verify that the breathing circuit is assembled correctly. To turn the ventilator on, press the power button at the back. The ventilator runs a self-test. When that is complete, select the correct patient group. To access tests and calibration functions, touch Pre-op Check in the standby window. The Tests and Calib window opens. A green check mark indicates the component is calibrated and ready, while a red X indicates the last calibration was unsuccessful. A box with no marks indicates the test or calibration has not been performed. If the CO2 sensor is not enabled, the box will be grayed out. Perform a tightness test and flow sensor calibration each time you have connected a new breathing circuit or component, including a flow sensor. The tightness test checks for leakage in the patient breathing circuit. To perform the tightness test, select the desired operation, then follow the instructions from the ventilator. Please note that wearing a glove is recommended. When the disconnect patient message appears, disconnect the test lung. When the message "Tighten patient system" is displayed, block the opening. After completing the tightness test, the message "Patient system tight" is displayed. Reconnect the test lung. When the test has been completed successfully, a check mark will appear in the tightness checkbox. To calibrate the flow sensor, select the desired operation, then follow the instructions from the ventilator. Disconnect the test lung and attach the calibration adapter to the flow sensor. When the message "Turn the flow sensor" appears, flip the flow sensor. Wait. And then, flip the flow sensor back to its starting position. Finally, disconnect the adapter from the flow sensor. When calibration has been completed successfully, make sure there is a green check mark in the flow sensor checkbox. If you are using a coaxial breathing circuit, perform the tightness test and flow sensor calibration before connecting an HME filter. Once the tightness test and the flow sensor calibration have been completed, place an HME filter between the patient and the flow sensor. As CO2 sensors are already calibrated at the factory, you only need a zero calibration with the first use of the sensor. When changing between airway adapter types, from single use to reusable, when the alarm CO2 calibration needed is generated. Connect the sensor to the ventilator and check if CO2 monitoring is enabled. Wait approximately 90 seconds for the device to warm up. If you haven't done so already, connect the airway adapter to the CO2 sensor and keep these components away from all sources of CO2 and the exhaust port of the expiratory valve. Do not move the CO2 sensor during zero calibration. When zero calibration is complete, make sure there is a green check mark in the CO2 sensor checkbox. Then connect the sensor with the airway adapter between the breathing circuit and the flow sensor. Before continuing, the CO2 sensor must be enabled for monitoring data to be available. Calibration of the oxygen sensor is only needed after installing a new galvanic oxygen sensor or when a related alarm occurs. Calibration is not required with a paramagnetic O2 sensor. As the galvanic oxygen sensor requires approximately 30 minutes to reach stable values, we recommend performing the calibration only after the oxygen sensor is warmed up. The calibration procedure can either be performed when the ventilator is in standby or during active ventilation. To perform calibration with 100% oxygen, set the oxygen control to 22% or higher. The gas source has to be connected. Calibrating at 100% improves the stability of measurements at higher oxygen concentrations during use. When calibration is complete, the message O2 Sensor Calibration OK is displayed. Make sure there is a green check mark in the O2 sensor checkbox. Once you have completed the preoperational checks, the ventilator is ready for use. You can set up the ventilator for a particular patient and start ventilation, or you can turn off the ventilator and keep it stored away, ready for use. All the test results of the preoperational checks will remain stored in the memory, even when the ventilator is turned off. Make sure the setup that you calibrated is not changed or altered while the ventilator is in storage. To turn off the ventilator, press the power button at the back of the ventilator.